It's going to be too much water in too short a period of time. And for those folks, I would just get ready for a lot of rain, a lot of water, a lot of wind over the next few days. And it's a very slow-moving storm. So two things that that means. One, that we'll be dealing with this at least through Tuesday. And secondly, that that means the trajectories have a lot more uncertainty than normal. Because it's so slow-moving, that means they really aren't that confident that it's going to make that, that it's going to follow exactly that path and take that rightward turn. And that's why it's important that folks pay attention to your local news, pay attention to the local officials as they update this information.
And hopefully they will pay attention. That was Louisiana Governor Bobby Jindal speaking about what's now Tropical Storm Lee, and it is expected to bring up to 15 inches of rain to his state, New Orleans, right in the path. That city was devastated 6 years ago by Hurricane Katrina, and this new storm is likely to bring very serious flooding. People there are doing everything they can to prepare, including Billy Nungesser, who is the Plaquemines Parish president, and he's taken a moment out to join us. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.
What are you telling your folks to do to prepare right now?
Well, we've pumped down all of our canals and areas where the water is retained as it's pumped out into the marsh. But 20 inches of rain, which is expected, we're hoping that spread over 3 days, because no area can take that heavy a rain in a concentrated time frame. Our biggest concern is the levees. You know, 6 years ago after Katrina, Congress approved these federal levees, and they still haven't started construction. So we're flood fighting in areas that, for a tropical storm, you would think would hold up. But we have some levees that are subpar that we're real concerned about that could flood the middle of the parish and put the people in the south end actually cut off from getting out of the parish.
It sounds, sir, like this is the worst possible type of storm that you can get because it will sit over where you are for such a long period of time with so much moisture.
Absolutely. That's our concern, is that storm surge beating against those private levees that have been authorized in the federal system but not built yet, because we saw that happen for Ike, deteriorated the levee, and Plaquemines Parish actually flooded for several weeks from Hurricane Ike, which we didn't take a direct hit.
Are folks
and we
heeding,
have that same concern.
I'm so sorry, sir. Are folks heeding the call there? Do you want them to leave if they can now?
Well, we're going to make that call tonight, depending on how strong this gets and how the levees hold up. And we'll open shelters in the north end of the parish and allow those people plenty of time to get out.
Surrounding areas you think affected as badly as you may be?
Well, we have that levee concern. I think the other surrounding areas is the amount of rain we're anticipating in a short period of time. None of the pumps in any of the areas will keep up with that kind of rainfall in just a concentrated area. So we're hoping those bands move in and out quickly and give the pumps a chance to catch up.
Well, Billy Nungesser, we know this will be a really tough weekend for you, the Plaquemines Parish President. We thank you for joining us, and we will be speaking to you again, hopefully. Stay safe. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Kelly?
And this storm, looking to be the first big test for New Orleans since Katrina, a lot of resources went into rebuilding and protecting the low-lying sections of the city to make sure they aren't flooded again. Trace Gallagher is live in our West Coast newsroom with more details on that kind of preparedness.
You know, Kelly, I just want to kind of expound on what Billy Nungesser was saying there. The astonishing fact that after $10 billion of rebuilding and repairing these levees, and some of them that haven't been built yet, that these levees by the Army Corps of Engineers have been graded as poor. I mean, they're given a Class 2 grading, which is the second worst grading you can get, which means that these things could be dangerous. They could fail if you get a big storm, Katrina or larger. This thing could dump a whole bunch of rain. This storm, by the way, is a double whammy as you look at kind of the levees that are being rebuilt and have been rebuilt over the past 6 years, because you're going to get that storm surge, which will push a lot of water up into Lake Pontchartrain. On top of that, as Nungesser was saying, the forecast for 15, maybe 20 inches of rain, if they got it all in one day, it would definitely flood the city because it's below sea level and the pumps you see here simply are not fast enough to keep up. Now, because the pumps won't keep up, then you've got the problem of trying to drain the water from Lake Pontchartrain. Again, more problems. I want to show you pictures of something that they call a concrete security blanket for New Orleans. This is on Lake Bourne. It's just outside of the city, and this is where all the water came into Lake Pontchartrain during Hurricane Katrina. This structure wasn't there 6 years ago. It's there now. It is 2 miles long, 12 feet wide. It's got pylons that go down some 200 feet below the water level. That would hold back a major surge coming into New Orleans. So if there is any solace for the people there, you've got that, which will stop a lot of the storm surge. The problem is that will not help when it comes to the rain. And if you get 15 or 20 inches in the New Orleans area, it is going to be very, very hard to get that water out in any short order, Kelly.
Trace, that's going to be very tough. We'll continue to keep an eye on the situation. Trace Gallagher, thank you.